Me, Ivo, I want to know if accepting things will make me complacent. I know you stress and other spiritual people stress the benefit of acceptance, but I sense that I don't accept things readily. It's a struggle and I know that I'm afraid I'll end up accepting something that's not in my greatest good. Today, for example, I was afraid if I stopped loathing all the cat hair that just seems to creep up around here and in places it shouldn't be, like my coffee cup, that I'll be one of those people with cat hair all over my clothing, and I don't want to be like that. Particularly since I'm allergic to cats anyway. Yes, why did I rescue one? Because it needed a new home. He was abandoned, so I put his needs before my own. To be honest, I'd rather get rid of my allergies than the cat. I think that's the way to go. Ivo, you are discussing the difference between acceptance and acceptance. These are two different matters. Acceptance is a question of not resisting that which is in your best interest, because your people do that. Acceptance is a problem for those who allow themselves to be controlled, and I must add that those who have been abused as children have more of a problem with acquiescing than other people do. But there is a problem in the thinking here. For those who don't understand what it means, it's basically giving in reluctantly without protest. My dear, what you must do first of all is give up your battle mentality. Waging a battle on cat hair is not the correct approach. The correct approach is to accept that you must do it for the sake of your health. You must look at this with more of a loving approach, rather than your lower fear-based approach. When you have this attack, battle mentality, you are up in arms over things that you do not want in your life. That is not to say that acceptance must be the end goal of all things, no. Some things are not acceptable, but in the case where you do not wish to give up your cat, you see that you must find a better way of looking at the problem, and this is acceptance. You must accept that vacuuming, dusting and washing your apartment more often is the way forward. You have allergies, yet you have the cat. You are not being forced to acquiesce. This is not about compliance, this is about choice. This is one example of how you resist that which you must accept. We watch many of you going through similar processes, struggling to find the correct healthier attitude to adopt or floundering in lower vibrational fear-based attitudes. My dear, you also see the hair situation as something you would like to resolve on its own. That is unrealistic thinking, and I believe you call it wishful thinking. The way to go forward towards acceptance is to accept your reality: you have a hair problem. Me, I was thinking of buying a new wardrobe, all orange and white clothing, so that way nobody can see the cat hair hanging off of my black pants. I was also thinking of going to the car wash and using one of those strong vacuums on my clothing. Ivo, yes, you have an excess of hair and dander in the house which aggravates your allergies. You have taken some logical steps to help your allergy situation. You are increasing your vacuuming. You also have cut back on peanut butter, which contains histamine, the compound that your body produces when it has an allergic reaction. You will buy your quercetin again now that summer is back, which also helps you. But there is more to dealing with your allergies, and it also involves the psychological aspect. The thymus gland regulates allergies, and it is in the area of the heart chakra. Me, say no more. Ivo, it would be wise to open your heart daily. It is open to some degree, but working on opening it more would help with your allergy problem. Also, you have said of your allergies that you are allergic to this planet, so when you affirm these things, your body will comply. Me, true. Ivo, it does not understand that you are being sarcastic. Me, I was thinking that for 12 years I worked at an oil additive factory. Already having allergies at that point in my life, and now I find out I have multiple chemical sensitivity. How about that? Ivo, not a coincidence. Your body reacts to what you expose it to. It is functioning as you have asked it to throughout your past. You have subjected it to a chemical factory and it has responded in the best way it could. You also eat many things you should not. A detox of the liver would be in order as well. I know you have plans for these things. These are all things you must accept. That you should not eat gluten and dairy. That organic is better for you. That your peanut butter habit would be better replaced with another nut butter, cost what it may. Do you see the process you're going through in coming to acceptance of your food choices and your life choices here? Even something as simple as cat hair is showing you your faulty process of resisting your truth. Me, I see that. You're really pointing out to me and people listening that even the simplest situation can have life-changing meaning and benefit. Ivo, yes. Many can examine their own lives in the same vein to learn as well. Simply look at what annoys you, or bothers you. Where is your thinking fear-based? It is showing you that you have an aggressive mentality with respect to things you do not like, such as cat hair. Where in actuality, peaceful calm and acceptance of your choice to live with it and to deal with it as something in your best interests, an expression of self-care, for example, is the best way to think about the situation. So for those listening, it is a process to understand when you are acquiescing to something that you do not wish to experience, and a process of self-empowerment when you finally wake up to realize that this is not acceptable anymore. Perhaps a relationship or particular problems within relationships are good examples to look for acquiescence. Me, or what the government shoves at us too. Like taxes. Ivo, that too. You do get something in return for the taxes you pay, however, but arguably, they are too high. The fact that you pay taxes on your paychecks, then again when you purchase, not to mention the hidden taxes you pay indicate that North Americans are heavily taxed. However, back to the subject at hand, breaking old childhood patterns of powerlessness can be difficult and one must look for them. To deal with today's simple problem, Sharon used methods of denial, hoping the hair problem would disappear. She used aggression, hoping that that would inspire her to attack the problem. She also saw the problem as not being one she had created for herself, also a form of denial. With an unhealthy dose of sarcasm on top, which is thinly disguised anger. Look at the emotion pyramid, my love. See that anger rates at a frequency of 150. There are higher states of being with higher vibrational frequencies that are more loving. My love, when you are angry, you are stuck in old childhood thinking and coping patterns, which are dysfunctional. That is another clue. Fear and anger. Me, yes, my old close friends. Ivo, again, sarcasm. This indicates that some of your childhood issues are undealt with because you are still using these old coping mechanisms to deal with your daily life, thereby frustrating yourself even more. My love, when you begin to describe a situation with "I am afraid," or "I was afraid that," that should be your first sign that there is a problem in your thinking. You are afraid. You are fearing. And there is nothing to fear when your mind is following a higher path. Your indicating that you are afraid indicates that it is not following a higher path. Fear resolves nothing. Do you see? Me, yes. Ivo, so, you must accept that this problem of yours, or what you call a problem, is because of your dislike of having cat hair in your face. Yes. Me, yes. Ivo, you are calling it a problem when it need not be. It is simply a preference. Your preference is to have a hair-free home. Me, speaking of which. I still have to flat out the blankets. Thanks for the reminder. Ivo, so you do what is necessary to limit the problem. Me, yes. Ivo, and you eradicate the wrong mental thinking. You choose to do this for yourself and to keep the cat as an expression of your compassion for it. It may also be worthwhile looking at whether your dislike of the hair could be hiding more resentment in the form of having been forced to take the cat in the first place, by the neighbor who abandoned him. Could you fuss over the hair in fact be hiding a deeper issue? You have complained about her irresponsibility and you have also complained about your over-responsibility and how you tend to get stuck with things others don't want to care for, such as a homeless man for example? Me, maybe. I didn't think of that. My 3 years of hell. I just wanted to do some good. Ivo, your good intentions backfired on you, my love. However, you have learned from this as well. It would be worthwhile to get back to journaling. When you write out your anger, it helps to draw it out of you. For all listening, resistance is fear-based. Fear-based thinking comes in all forms: denial, minimization, aggression, passivity, acquiescence, and there are more. Study the cognitive distortions to see where you are prone to not engage in a more loving way of thinking. Attempt to raise your response to a more caring, more loving and self-compassionate response. Understand it may take effort, but know it as an act of self-love. Anger is a transitory emotion. It is the bridge between the lower and the higher emotional states. It is not a place to reside. It is an indicator that something is amiss. That is all. When you are of a higher emotional state, feeling anger is a sign your state is dropping. When you are in a lower emotional state, anger is a sign of improvement and often brings on change. Taking correct action is the next step, not engaging in distorted thinking as Sharon has been. Me, this is a good subject. Maybe the example was a bit right, but nonetheless. Ivo, we will discuss more of these. First of all, rid yourself of the aggressive, attack mentality and see your response as based in self-care and of love for Merlin. Me, okay, thank you Ivo. Ivo, my love, I watch over you. I let you figure it out for yourself as you are wont to do, and it is difficult at times to watch you suffer needlessly. But you must learn. I hope our videos make many lives easier.